I'm here in downtown Manhattan, New York, USA, at the very southmost tip of Broadway. One of the many things I love about New York is, like a lot of US cities, it has a fantastic grid system for its streets. In New York, though, they've even numbered them. They actually have a numbered coordinate system for streets, except for Broadway. Broadway cuts across the other streets on a strange angle. If the other streets are a coordinate system, Broadway is a linear graph. It's a line cutting through all of them. And if it's a linear graph, it must have an equation. And I'm gonna do it. I'm here in New York. I've actually gone and gotten some graph paper, so I'm gonna make a video of me walking up Broadway, plotting points, and calculating its linear equation. Or I'm gonna make a video of me walking around New York getting my phone stolen. You know, whatever happens first. I've taken a side trip up Houston Street, which is right in front of me over here, because by the early 19th century, that's about how far the then sprawling New York City had reached. And it was pretty obvious it was going to carry on going much further north up the island. And so, after a lot of careful calculation and consideration, in 1811, a plan was put in place so that all streets going further north would be on a grid. It would start just north of Houston Street with First Street and then carry on counting all the way up. Second Street, Third Street, Fourth Street, all the horizontal streets, if you consider north to be up, would be numbered sequentially. The streets that go vertically were called avenues, and they were also numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, although slightly annoyingly, they started on the right and numbered to the left, the opposite direction to what we would normally do on a plot. Here's my vertical axis, which are the streets. Okay, that is the avenues. That's fine, we have avenues running this way, we have streets running that way. We can go and plot where Broadway lies. Although, before then, out of curiosity, I wonder what's at the origin. So here it is, the intersection of First and First. This is the bottom right-hand corner of the grid, which actually means I've moved one down and one to the right, and very sadly there are no zeroth streets in New York, but the corner here of Avenue A and First Street is the origin. And so that point there, that signpost, is the origin point of the grid in New York City. For a while, Broadway is quite well behaved. For the first 10 blocks of the grid system, it goes directly parallel with the avenues. It goes straight up as a kind of asymptote. But then here, at the intersection with 10th Street, is where it changes. Instead of carrying on straight in that direction, it changes its mind and goes off on its jaunty angle. At last, we can start some data collection.
So we've come along 4 and we've gone up 12.
We are off and racing. Fun fact about Union Square is named after the middle of a rectangular Venn diagram. I've actually drawn it so you can see there's section A, section B.
Parts of a Venn diagram. And B equals places in New York City. In here is Union Square.
Now I've put Union Square in the Union Square while it's in Union Square. Here it is. Broadway has hit 5th Avenue and it's happened right on 24th Street, fantastically, with the famous Flatiron Building in the background. One of the problems with a diagonal road going across a grid system is you end up with orphaned little triangles of land. And one such bit of land has been put to good use with a triangular building. This is the flat iron building. It is a triangular shaped base to fit on a tiny bit of land that's cut off by Broadway. And so of course, it should be a right angled triangle. But I'm gonna check. I'm gonna measure the three different sides and make sure the sum of the squares of the two smaller sides equals the square of the larger side. And I'm in America, so I can't think of a better way to measure distances than with feet.
Okay, here is the flat iron building in front of me, and here's my diagram of it. I am going to start in this exact point here. I'm gonna count my steps all the way down that side, and then gonna cut across the back, and I'll come back up this side and calculate how right the triangle is.
24 feet. Two, three, four, five, 95 feet. 243 feet.
Flat iron measurements made. That was incredibly awkward. Now we see how the calculations work out.
95 squared equals 59,201. 243 squared 9. That
it's not bad.
It's less than 0.26% error.
The flat iron building is a right angled triangle. Fun fact, New York City is actually built on top of an underground cloud, which is a bit like an aquifer, but more magical. Of course, sometimes the pressure builds up too much. In that case, they stick a giant straw into the ground, and that releases some of the built-up cloud. Clouds aside, Broadway crosses 33rd Street right when it hits 6th Avenue. Broadway has now brought me right into Times Square, where I can sadly report very little multiplication seems to be taking place, but I've also located the intersection of 45th and 7th. Thank goodness I love crowds. Okay, I somehow missed 8th Avenue, but that's fine. I'm now at the intersection of Broadway with Lincoln and Columbus and 65th Street, and 9th Avenue becomes Columbus, so frankly, this is good enough to be a data point for me. And finally, here we are where Amsterdam Avenue, effectively 10th Avenue, hits 71st Street, hits Broadway. And this is our final data point. After this, Broadway kind of curls around again, straightens out, and starts to follow the grid once more. We now have the data we need for the linear section of Broadway. We can calculate its equation. Okay, there we have the final linear plot. You can see it is not quite a straight line, but that's fine. We can now put on a line of best fit and then get the equation for that. Okay, there is my line of best fit, and I've worked out the equation. The street equals 9.975 times the avenue minus 26.5 blocks. And the r squared value, a measure of how close it is to a proper linear fit, is 0.995. That's incredible. So there you have it. I had to spend nearly all day walking up Broadway, but we now know it is a near exact linear plot. Its equation for the street is 9.975 times the avenue minus 26.5 blocks. But why stop there? It's a linear plot. So I realized I can do the reverse function. So I flipped it around. If you are on any street in New York on the linear part of Broadway, so between pretty much 10th Street and 71st Street, you can take the street number you're on, you can divide that by 10, you can add 2.7, round it to the nearest a half, and that will tell you which avenue Broadway will cross that street on. Or if it's a half, you know that it crosses between two avenues. And so there you are, some practical New York mathematics.